section for us, and then...
Okay, my monologue that I wrote is about a girl who was doing the 42-mile run in the Holocaust, and how she went through it and how she survived it, and she's telling the story. It was so hard. I don't get how I survived it. Me, just me, running 42 miles in the snow. I'm already lucky to have survived this far in the Holocaust, but not lucky enough to run 42 miles and live through it. The only other time that I've actually ran was when I was a little kid playing hide and seek or tag. Nothing like this. Anyway, let me tell you my story. A few days before we were going to run, there were rumors going around saying that we would be liberated soon. They said that the war front was drawing near to the camp and that we'd soon all be free. But when they told us that we were leaving, I was devastated, totally and utterly devastated. I had actually believed that I would be free and that I would be able to start a new life. Well, was I mistaken? We started off at a simple march, but it gradually turned out to a full-out sprint that you couldn't stop. And if you did, they killed you. If you were too slow and fell behind, they shot you like you were just a practice target. All around you, people were dying, either from being shot or from not being able to go on any longer. As I was running, my legs felt like they were getting heavier and heavier. And to make it worse, I kept tripping over everything. In the cold, it could kill you. After hours of running, I felt like I would fall over and my body ached so bad. But something told me that I needed to keep on going. Soon, I had been running for so long, I couldn't feel anything anymore. I only had the sense that wind was rushing down my face and snow was falling on my head. The rest of my body just moved mechanically, without any feeling. Suddenly, I heard people saying that we were arriving at the camp. I then went through the same deadly process as Ellie, with no food and no water. When I was finally liberated in 1945, I decided that I had to tell my story to others. And so I came here and told my story to you guys, and hoping you'll tell my story to other people you know, and everybody will know what happened to me and so many other people in